have changed my mourning into dancing, O Lord, and you have girded me with joy. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask this day of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. My heart exalts in the Lord, my Saviour.
The bows of the mighty are his poverty and riches. He brings men low and raises them on high.
My heart exalts the Lord my Saviour.
He lifts the lowly from the dust, from the dung heap he raises the poor, to set them in the company of princes, to give them a glorious throne.
My heart exalts in the Lord my Saviour.
Alleluia. We are told what eternity is, but perhaps we do not really believe it, or at least we live as if we don't. We do not amend our lives by penance and by reparation, as encouraged by God throughout the millennia and repeated by Our Lady of Fatima in 1917. Of prayer, she encouraged especially devotion to the Most Holy Rosary and revealed herself as the Lady of the Rosary. And through devotion to her Immaculate Heart, we meditate on the inner life of the Blessed Virgin Mary, of her purity, of her love and of what God does and did in her. We meditate on this so that we might be filled with grace as she was filled with grace, and therefore bear the image and likeness of her Son and her God, our Lord Jesus Christ, more and more every day. The devotion to the Immaculate Heart is also a devotion to the most sacred heart of our Lord, so that we might gaze on that through it mercy was given to the world and beg mercy for ourselves. Penance, prayer, and devotion to the Immaculate Heart of the Blessed Virgin. Let us therefore meditate and contemplate these things, perhaps for the rest of May, the month dedicated to Our Lady. These might be in our minds particularly, how we can increase in these by the grace of God, and therefore fulfill the message, the command that she gave to the children at Fatima. And we must remember as well that as devotion to her Immaculate Heart spread throughout the world, as it was spreading before the apparitions, we must remind ourselves and be reminded that in the end, her Immaculate Heart will triumph. We do not know when, we do not know the precise manner of this triumph, but we know that God, in his mercy and in his love, will cause her heart to triumph. Let us dedicate ourselves, therefore, to the message of Our Lady in these times, prayer, penance, and devotion to that Immaculate Heart, that we might love the Lord our God more and more. Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us. Concordit et ipsia, Locus amest ipsia, Maria precaria, Reconat Ecclesia, Virgo Maria, Quae felici Gaudio, Resurgente Domino, Floruit ut vivium, Quam concentu parili, corima percelici, et nos conceressibus, novum me nos pangibus, Virgo Maria. O Regina Virgio, potis fades supplicus, et pos mortis stadium, Ite contemplatis, Virgo Maria. Gloriosa Trinitas, in divisa unitas, ob Maria merita, nos salva per secula, Virgo Maria.
Receive, Holy Father, this offering of our humility, which we bring you with joy as we commemorate the Blessed Virgin Mary. And grant, we pray, that it may be for us who are joined to the sacrifice of Christ, our consolation on earth and our eternal salvation, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation,
always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the feast day of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sanctus. Plenis concedia est terra, gloria tua.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection, until you come again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as ones who are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation in the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through Christ our Lord. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share of fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not paying our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the world's man.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Agnus Dei, qui est omnes peccatoribus, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui est omnes peccatoribus, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui est omnes peccatoribus, dona nobis patria.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not aware that you should enter under my roof, but in a safe word, and my supper shall be.
The 13th of May, the covered area, a pillar around the Virgin Maria. Ave, ave, ave Maria.
Ave, ave,
mortal flesh, the life of Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Michael, the Archangel,
defend us in the day of battle. Be our safe guard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust out of hell Satan and all the wicked spirits,
who are